Well, for more on this, we're joined now by lawyer, political strategist, and friend of the show, Erin Elmore. She's been covering all the details. Erin, hi, how are you? What is the feeling there?
Great, how are you?
Great. Tell us, what's the feeling there at the courthouse?
My boots on the ground are telling me that everyone is cautiously optimistic, but they've been dealing with this in the small community of Montgomery County, just outside of Philadelphia, for a very, very long time. So they're ready to see a resolution. They're ready to see the media circus go away, and they're ready to see justice.
What do you think is most likely to happen to Cosby?
Well, as you mentioned, he is facing three counts here, could carry up to 30 years total. And trust me, he could get hit with the top end of the sentencing guidelines because let's face it, he's a violent sexual criminal with several victims. Those things do not bode well for him. The only thing that really bodes well for him, if you want to put that in quotation marks, is the fact that he's very, very old, allegedly pretty sick, and this was his quote unquote first offense. What do I think he's actually going to get instead of the 30? I think he'll do 3 to 10 years.
Wow.
And that means he will likely die in prison, or he could die before he does go to prison. You guys touched on the fact that there's this thing called bail pending appeal. Now, his lawyer, as a defense lawyer, has to ask for that because then it triggers the appeals process, if you will. But knowing Judge O'Neill and knowing how he's treated similarly situated defendants, I think, as my favorite judge said, get your toothbrush, get your sneakers, because you're going to jail. He is not going to likely walk out of that courthouse in Montgomery County today. Mm-hmm. It is likely that he's had time to get his world in order. He was convicted in April. It is now September. He has had the time he needs to prepare his life for jail, and I do not think he is going home today.
Wow, good. And what do you think that this will mean in regard to the Me Too movement, Erin?
Well, judges aren't really allowed to weigh these sort of social issues. I think clearly it's having an impact on the way that things are conducted in our criminal justice system. Bruce Castor was the district attorney in this county, and he chose many years ago, I believe it was 2008, not to prosecute Bill Cosby. So now we see these Harvey Weinsteins of the world, these Les Moonveses of the world. We see them having to be accountable for the actions, and this is another instance of accountability and possible jail time for doing something completely inappropriate.
Thank you so much,
Erin.
And you
know what's going on right now in Montgomery County at the courthouse? This is going to be a two-day sentencing situation. Right now, what they're working on is they're handling the sexually violent predator part of this. And what that means, I'm just reading the notes from my lawyers on the ground there, that Cosby wouldn't cooperate with the psychologists. So she's using her notes and she's giving testimony to make her decisions. So once we get through that, we'll get to Andrea Constant, we'll get to a few other items, and then we're going to get down to the sentencing and the nitty-gritty.
Wow. Thank you, Erin. Appreciate it.